These look like security monitors. What are they doing here?
Monitoring us. I can't actually look and see what's on the display. Uh-oh. Oh, wow. Hi. I hope there wasn't anything else to look at that I missed.
Ah, Amy Willard. You found me. I was hoping you would.
You were?
How did you...
I realize you probably have many questions.
Just a few.
I can give you all the answers you need. But first, allow me to make myself more presentable.
You look like a normal person.
So you are human.
Yes. I'm sorry to disappoint you if you were expecting more.
I don't know what I was expecting, to be honest.
Hmm. What's with the mechanical ravens?
Why the mechanical ravens? What do they do?
Rather clever little inventions, wouldn't you say? They have video transmitters in their eyes and audio transmitters in their beaks. Huh. I use them as scouts, since I can control them remotely.
Did you make them?
No, someone else did, a long time ago. In any case, they've served me quite well, at least the ones that haven't broken. I have very few left, which is going to be a problem at some point.
Hmm. So you're a doctor?
You told me you were a doctor.
Yes, Dr. Edwin Aquino, at your service.
Okay.
I was once the leader of the Green Lung Vaccine Development Team.
Oh.
But after learning about their vaccine distribution, or lack thereof, that quickly changed.
Hang on. You knew about the vaccine hoarding? Why didn't you tell anyone?
That would have started violent riots. It's not fair to begin a civil war when it would end without a cure for the illness. I wanted to say something. It hurt not to, but the time wasn't right.
Hmm. You didn't think the people deserved to know?
They do, and they will. But not while we only have a vaccine and not a cure. With a permanent cure, the aristocracy's hoarding becomes irrelevant, and the focus will be on eradicating the disease.
I guess that makes sense.
True. Why have you been watching me?
You've been following me with your birds. Why am I of such interest to you?
You did a lottery job for the Ministry of Energy.
That's right. What of it?
You've got the disease. You're fighting to survive. You're clever and resourceful. Exactly what I need.
Exactly what do you need?
After I left the Ministry of Medicine, I began my attempts at developing a permanent cure for Green Lung. It was a long process, which took over 10 years. But just last month, I had a breakthrough and was able to make this.
Is that?
Yes. This is the cure for Green Lung.
Wow.
I've been testing it and it seems to work, but I need to be certain. Aside from that, I don't have the information necessary to mass produce the cure, though I suspect Tiberius keeps it somewhere in the Ministry of Energy.
So what is it you need from me?
We're both fugitives, Amy. I can't put myself at risk by going to the places I need to. If I'm killed or captured, my research will have all been for nothing. You can clearly take care of yourself. I saw how you handled things at Rockwall Prison and Willowdale Plaza.
Thanks.
You helped me out both of those times.
True, yeah.
I merely provided some assistance. Your survival was your own doing. Now, I realize it's a bit much to ask, but your help would be incredibly valuable, not just to me, but to the future of humanity.
It's not really much to ask. I owe you my life, after all.
Thank you, Amy. I appreciate it. The main thing I need is to find out where Tiberius is keeping my research on mass production. At some point, I'll also need a subject to test the cure on, so I can be absolutely sure it works.
Try it on me.
Do you have any questions?
What do you know about Tiberius?
Can you tell me anything about Tiberius?
Quite a bit. I've known him for a very long time. Since before the bombs, in fact. Was there anything specific you wanted to know?
Oh, we can find out all this, okay. What did he do before the bombs?
What was Tiberius like before the bombs?
He was the director of the Ministry of Energy. Of course, back then he wasn't calling himself Tiberius. He was just Julian.
Julian?
After society collapsed, he took the initiative to reform and establish the aristocracy. His love for history led him to adopt the alias of Tiberius, as well as insisting the other aristocrats take the name of ancient Roman emperors.
Why does he wear that awful mask?
Anonymity. He felt government leaders are more respected as an institution rather than as people. I can't deny that this approach works extremely well.
Why has he got a soothsayer?
Strange for him to have a soothsayer for an assistant. How is he qualified?
Superstition is a very powerful force. I'm living proof of that. I never had many dealings with the soothsayer, but I believe he came from somewhere outside the city. Tiberius finds comfort in being able to have a channel to the supposed other side. While I don't share his beliefs, I can't particularly fault him for having them.
Has he always been evil? I'm not sure. Evil is a rather simplistic word to describe him. He was honest with me.
Was he always so evil?
I wouldn't call him that.
See?
Manipulative, yes. Ruthless, undoubtedly. But not evil. He suffered immense trauma on the day the bombs fell.
Everyone did. Not all of us had the wealth to recover so easily.
Tiberius lost both his wife and unborn child that day. Wealth or not, that hits a man hard.
Wow.
It left him quite mentally unstable, to be honest. His determination to rebuild society was rooted in trying to cope with his loss. In a way, I felt pity for him. Perhaps too much.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing. Never mind.
So you psychoanalyzed him as well. That's all I want to know for right now.
That's all for now.
Fair enough.
You wear strange clothes for a doctor.
Why do you dress like that?
Superstition.
Intimidation, mainly. The work I do is not exactly looked upon favorably by the government, so I had to come up with a way to make sure I was left alone. The costume is just to make sure anyone who might happen to see me is scared off.
So you knew of the rumors about the Reaper and decided to become him yourself?
No. I'm the one who started them.
Yeah, that's what
Creating the image of death personified seemed a natural deterrent for anyone who might get too close. Thankfully, the rumor seemed to have spread rather quickly over the years.
You aren't kidding. There's a whole cult dedicated to worshipping you.
Yes. I know of them. An extreme example, but I can't deny it helps my work.
Can you imagine these people, this cult, finding out that this is just a guy in a suit who uses gliders and these ravens? Who made the ravens? But yeah, it's... That would, yeah, kind of floor them. Shake their whole existence. How do I find the mass production information?
How can we find the mass production information?
Ideally, I could use my ravens to go in and locate it, but I only have 3 working ones left. And as you're well aware, Tiberius's tower is huge. It would take way too long for only 3 ravens to scan the entire place without being detected.
Could I take a look at one of them?
Of course.
Who did you say made these?
A friend in the Ministry of Knowledge. But that was ages ago. I know very little about their design.
Nelson?
It isn't too complex, actually. I can fix them for you, no problem.
You can?
Sure. See this bit here? That's the servo. The part that controls the wings. It's worn out, so I just need to replace it with a new one.
That was quick.
Are those common? Would we be able to find one or more in the city?
Well, I learned about them from working on toy airplanes that my friend had when we were kids. If we could find some, we'd be in business.
I wonder...
The airplane at the church.
Yes, excellent. As I suspected, there's a hobby shop which has remained mostly intact further in the city. And I can see that they have several model airplanes.
Okay,
right,
then.
I'll go get them and fix your ravens in no time.
Yes, but... The store is located in the quarantine zone.
So? I have nothing to worry about. I'm already infected.
You contracting green lung isn't my concern.
Yeah.
It's how you're going to get back out.
Can't get out.
The quarantine zone is designed to keep people from escaping.
If I can find a way in, I'll just have to find a way out, won't I?
Fine. While you're there, see if you can bring someone back with you. Someone who has been quarantined will make an ideal subject to test the cure on.
I'll see what I can do.
Good. Take this, then.
What is it?
a two-way communicator. They used to call them walkie-talkies.
Oh, okay.
You can use them to stay connected while you're in there.
Cool. I'll just get to it then.
Good luck, Amy. By the way, that doorway back there will allow you to get up and down the tower much easier than climbing.
That's good. Very much appreciated.
This is my way of communicating directly with the Dr. Aquino. He's hard at work tinkering with one of those mechanical ravens. Hey, Doctor?
Yes?
I'll just get to it then.
Good luck, Amy.
Oh, I don't have an opportunity now to tell him that I'll be his test subject.
An old radio and some kind of electronic music equipment. They've surely been scavenged for parts. Just as I suspected. Empty. Nice. I've never heard one of these played before. I'm not a musician. Or a thief. It's fake, I hope. It's too high to reach.
It's mechanical.
I had something like this one. It's too high to reach. Just as I...
A teapot?
Ugh, looks like it's got fungus growing out of it.
Oh, did I look at that already?
I can't reach it. I don't know the first thing about hang gliding. I'd probably just fall straight down to the ground. What an interesting contraption. I wonder if I'd be able to make one of my own.
That'd be awesome.
It doesn't look as intimidating from all the way over here. If only it were that easy.
Okay. Well, we go out this way then. Alright, quarantine zone. I notice we can't go back to the marketplace now. Let me just look around in here for a second.
Excuse me.
What?
All right.
See, I immediately thought of the plane here. But we want a model plane.
There's nothing else in there that I can use. That does not...
What if we told her the Reaper is just a guy?
Excuse me?
Yes? Have a good me death.
What can I...
I don't have any option. I'm not sure if I'd take it to begin with.
Hello there.
Hi.
Have a good...
I was just trying to hit the exit. So before I go to the quarantine zone, I'm just going to put another save. Quarantine zone.
Quarantine zone. For a lot of people, this is one of the last signs they ever get to read.
There's no signs in there, I guess?
Quarantine zone. A safety sign. Looks to be warning against riding on the back of the trains. That doesn't look like it's a very pleasant job.
Bridge.
Nice. I think trains used to cross here when they would go in and out of the Central Business District. Way too dangerous to cross on foot. That doesn't look like... Excuse me.
Huh? What do you want?
What the hell are you doing?
What is it you're doing out here?
Transporting people into the quarantine zone. What does it look like?
No.
Aren't you worried about getting infected?
Just standing there.
Well, considering this is a lottery job, not really.
Doesn't make any sense. A lottery job, you just get a ticket to maybe, if your lottery gets pulled, get a vaccine. Which then you would need one for the following month and the following month, so... Yeah, I would be concerned if I were you. Well, I need to get in.
I need to get inside the quarantine zone.
Huh. You know, I think that's the first time I've ever heard anyone say that. Why on earth would you want to go into the quarantine zone? There's nothing in there except the sick and dying.
I'm trying to find a friend.
There's a friend of mine inside, who I'm looking for.
I hate to break it to you, but people only get sent in there when it's close to the end. I'd forget about your friend if I were you. Mm.
I need to get inside.
So you said, but I still don't understand why you'd want to go in there.
I'm scavenging for parts.
I'm a scavenger. I'm looking for some parts I need.
Then take my advice and go somewhere else. No scavenger that ever went inside the zone ever got back out. That's just the way the place is built. You don't look like someone with a death wish. So do yourself a favor and just forget about it.
Yeah, as I thought, she's not going to let us in unless we tell her we have green lung.
I need to get inside the quarantine zone.
So you said.
I have green lung.
I've got green lung.
Is that so? You look pretty healthy to me.
That may be, but I can assure you I've got it.
Look, my orders are to take people in who are at the terminal phase, and you clearly aren't. So unless you can prove otherwise, my hands are tied. Why are you trying to get in there anyway? If I was you, I would avoid telling anyone I was sick.
I have my reasons.
I'm sure you do.
Keep up the good work.
Thanks.
Yep, as I suspected, we have to kill her. Boom.
I can't just go around shooting people.
I don't think we have any bolts.
My trusty crossbow. It's out of ammo right now.
Yeah.
I don't think she'd be interested in that.
Oh, I was gonna whack her upside the head. I don't think she'd be interested in this either.
I don't think... Hello? Can you hear me?
Mr. Reaper?
Loud and clear.
How are things going on your end?
Everything going okay with you?
Yes. How are you faring?
Slowly, but surely. I'll be in touch.
Could you help me prove that I'm dying?
I need proof that I'm dying.
A rather odd request.
Yes, but if I'm going to get into the quarantine zone, I need the gatekeeper to think I'm sick enough.
Start coughing a lot?
I may have a plan. I just hope you aren't faint of heart.
Trust me, I'm not.
Good. Go out and see if you can find someone who has recently died of green lung. Then use your communicator to let me know. I should be able to help you further from there.
Okay, but how will I be able to tell if they died of green lung?
Autopsy?
Look for green sputum around the body and pustules around the wrists. Those are the two telltale signs.
Okay, I think I know where to go.
Over and out.
Over here... There's a recently dead body. Is it... Well, is it here? I think it's here. Sector 67. This person here.
Doesn't look like he's been here that long. Looks like he's got pustules on his wrists. And there's a small puddle of green goo on the ground next to him.
Ew.
This person was definitely a victim of green lung.
So we need to put this stuff on ourselves?
This guy died of green lung. A terrible way to go. Doesn't look like he's... Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes. Loud and clear.
I found someone who died of green lung.
I found our patient.
Excellent. Where is the body located?
in Sector 67, right near that painting.
I'll meet you there shortly.
Okay. Now fly on over here. That was very quick.
Poor soul. Hopefully this site will soon be a thing of the past. Step over there if you would, Amy. I need room to work.
Okay. You're gonna tear stuff apart, aren't you? Oh, you even got a scythe. Look at that.
Here, take this.
What's that?
A severed arm?
Yes. Notice the pustules around the wrist. Those are the telltale signs of the terminal phase of Green Lung. With some trickery on your part, you should be able to use this to get into the quarantine zone.
Okay. Thanks.
Bye. So we just put this on our own wrist? Wouldn't that make us even more sick?
The hand is partly decomposed, and there's pustules around the wrist. I can't believe I'm carrying this around with me. At least it doesn't smell.
I'm surprised it doesn't.
Hello?
Yes. Loud and clear.
Everything going okay with you?
Yes. How are you faring?
Slowly, but surely. Over and out.
Well, you can't access yourself as in like an object. Otherwise I'd put the arm on me. Let's head back to the bridge, I guess.
This is a path not many people get to return on.
True that. Here, this is my arm.
Like this is my arm, but if she sees the hand in its current condition, she'll know something's up.
What else would we do with the arm?
I'm not...
She sees the hand in its current condition?
I'm not sure...
So we want to use the arm, but not... the hand?
I can't believe I'm carrying this around with me. At least it doesn't smell. The hand is partly decomposed.
Okay, so the hand is partly decomposed, but the arm is not. So we need to separate the hand, I think, from the arm. But how do we do that?
Hello?
Yes.
Everything going okay?
Yes.
Slow. Over and out.
Well, what's her name has a sword. Maybe we can cut it off. Have her cut it off. Danton, maybe?
Danton?
What is it?
Time for me to go.
If you need a place to hide,
I don't think she'd be interested in that.
Damn it. Thought she might be able to cut the hand part off. I don't think there's anything else I can use down here.
Are you doing?
Yeah.
I don't need...
I need something sharp? Back to the Reaper's lair? I mean, he is a doctor. Use a shard to cut it off?
A shard of uranium glass. I don't see how I... Hey, doctor?
Yes?
I'll just get to it then.
Good luck, Amy.
I don't think he'd be interested in that. An old radio and some kind of electronic music equipment. They've surely been scavenged for parts. Just as I suspected. Empty. I can see why people are afraid of the Reaper.
Don't fear the Reaper, dude.
Please don't touch that.
I'll touch it all I like.
There's nothing inside except an old birdcage liner. I wonder if there was once a raven in there.
Well, I don't know. He's a doctor. I figured he could help me with the arm. Unless we want to chop off our own arm, I don't know.
No thanks.
We are going there.
No sputum or pustules. This person didn't die of green lung.
We already found our customer.
Creepy. Those are some nice gloves it's got on, though.
Get the gloves.
The mannequin's in even worse shape now.
Oh, we can't go in there, right? Oh, that's the way there. Okay. Ugh. We can't just go... Okay. You use the arm on the mannequin.
I don't see how I can use that there.
Oh, come on, there's gloves.
I shouldn't mess with it any further.
We want the gloves from it. Are you kidding me? Oh, we have the gloves. I didn't realize we even took them.
They're not in bad shape. Won't be much use if I need to protect my hands, though.
I didn't even realize she took them. Here we go.
Maybe this will help.
Severed arm with glove.
The glove actually makes it look like the hand is intact.
Mm-hmm. So the quickest way is to go through here, and then back out, and then to the quarantine zone.
Excuse me.
Huh? What do you want?
Keep up the good work.
Thanks.
I guess we just go like this?
Excuse me.
Yeah? What is it?
Take a look at this.
Oh, jeez. You weren't kidding. We have to get you inside.
Huh?
Climb up on the cart here and let's get a move on.
Get a move on. Hey, hey.
This place.
Hobbies.
Well, well. Fresh meat.
Uh-oh.
I beg your pardon?
Welcome to the quarantine zone, honey. Now shut up.
New
boys.
Meat. Oh. Hey.
What are you...
So, this is how things are going to work, okay? My guys are going to search you and take anything we like. Once we do that, you don't follow us or ever talk to us again. Curl up wherever you want and wait until you die. Anything good on her?
Yeah, a crossbow, radio, baseball bat, a piece of metal, and a severed arm.
Can have the arm.
It's always the clean ones that are the freaks. Let her keep her little toy. Take the rest.
Hey,
let go of me!
I need that radio.
Enjoy your stay while you can.
How dare you? I'll get you. By golly, I will.
The heavily fortified gate. Only one way, apparently.
Well, that was wonderful.
There's no going back out through there. I wonder what this used to be.
Hobby store, or this was.
It's sealed up. I can't get inside.
Burning bodies. Speechless.
I am not touching those.
That's a good idea.
I am...
Corpse pile.
Ugh, that smell. No.
No. A door, a sign.
I'm guessing it used to say hobbies. This is the place.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sure I can see anything useful to do there.
Anything else before we go in here? Last one to die. Please turn out the lights.
Last one to die, please turn out the light. I'd rather not. It looks like this was painted on with blood. Poor man. Doesn't look like he went peacefully.
Look at him hanging there.
He hasn't got anything of value on him that I can see.
Oh no, these people are gonna take everything.
A Corinth Duke. I haven't seen one of these in ages. I haven't got time to scavenge for parts now. Maybe when this is all over.
Kind of doubt it.
That was probably an advertisement once. It's too faded to read now. I don't think that would be a good idea. Oh my god. Things don't look good, but I'm not at that point just yet.
Ground zero.
That goes further into the quarantine zone. I can see the main blast site from here. Oh my. Things don't look. I'm not going any further into the zone until I get those servos.
Right. Into the hobby store then. Oh, yep, they took everything but the severed arm. Wonderful.
It's still in good shape.
Oh, brother.
Oh, God. I guess he wanted to go out on his own terms. I'm not going to touch him. It's disrespectful. A cash register. It's been a long time since this got used.
No kidding.
Not surprisingly, it's empty. A Mabel Cody model biplane. I've never seen an actual one of these in real life.
Guess we can get the servo from there, but I want to look around some more before we do that.
I can't tell if it's worse out there or in here. Another victim of Green Lung. Looks like they've been here for quite some time. There isn't much left of this person to search. A bunch of sealed boxes containing model radio-controlled airplanes.
What could be in there?
Nice. It kind of looks like the one in the salt flats. It's too high to reach. A mother and her child. At least they died together. I'll let them rest in peace. Not too much left on it, but there's some kits to put together model cars and airplanes, along with some radio-controlled versions. It's just a display model. It hasn't got a servo.
Alright, so the things are in here.
Great. 12 boxes still sealed. These servos will work perfectly.
Awesome.
Amy, not you two.
Oh, Gordon? That's where he went to.
Gordon? What happened to you?